On a busy sports day in the Twin Cities, fans arriving in downtown St. Paul for a battle with the Canucks. Minnesota currently holding one of the wild card spots in the West after a win against Winnipeg last night. Vancouver, on the other hand, a long way from a playoff position as they head into the second half of the season. On the forecheck, Brodin around to Dumba and ahead at center. Eric Staal races in for Minnesota, has Ennis driving the net, and his shot is steered aside by Markstrom. Extra man opportunity for Minnesota. 1-for-12 in the last three games. Spurgeon gives to Granlund. Down low, Koivu out front, Zucker scores!
He might start pleading that the bye week be pushed back a little ways. Now that he's got the heat, look at this shot. Just picks a corner, and it's the quick bang-bang play. Best power plays always have a couple of quick little passes and then a good hard shot.
Dubnyk snatches this one out of the air, and we get a whistle. Back in the middle, it's Granlund. Now Dumba floats one toward the net, and it's deflected wide by Koivu.
And it was very effective, even against a team like the Jets with big bodies out there.
Here's Coyle moving in, and a pad saved by Markstrom. Eriksson relays it around for Sedin. Into the middle, Sedin takes a return pass from Granlund. Across for Besser, who fires, saved by Dubnyk. Henrik Sedin over the Minnesota line, takes a return pass, and Eriksson scores. It trickled through the pads of Dubnyk. Eriksson, who's starting to come to life for Vancouver.
Last year with Vancouver, he had 11 in 65 games, and the year before that, though, he had 30. So this is a guy who knows how to score goals when he's on his game, and this Ennis just gets a little bit too deep right there.
Delzato, long lead pass, and here's Besser in alone. He sent it wide. Taken away by Dowd out to the line. Chaput, his shot was deflected. Prosser stepped on the puck and went down. Able to get it ahead to Foligno to the line, but Hutton holds. And a long shot is held by Dubnyk. And now Suter back to Spurgeon. 6 points in his last six games. Drops to Zucker. A shot. Save Markstrom. Spurgeon denied on the rebound. Plays it into the corner. Berti centers, and a redirect goes over the top of the goal off the stick of Sutter. Wild hanging on right now. The Canucks are threatening. Berti fires. Glove saved by Dubnyk. No question about it. The numbers he posted in his short time at North Dakota were simply amazing. 60 points as a freshman. Spurgeon pressuring Gagne. Gagne to Tanev. Throws it toward the net, and Dubnyk will snatch it out of the air and hang on. Delzato's shot right into the glove of Dubnyk, who hangs on. After this game tonight, they'll have played four fewer than Minnesota. Coyle hits the Vancouver line, drops to Spurgeon. His shot saved by Markstrom. Rebound controlled by Ennis, but Markstrom has lost his helmet.
Goaltenders are shaking their mask off. And this one looks like it catches him up, but look at the snap came off. You could see it. And so then naturally you want to get rid of it.
Winnick out to the line. Brodin with a dangerous pass taken away by Berti. Berti has Marcus Granlund with him, and a poke kick by Dubnyk breaks it up.
Talked about a turnover in the defensive zone that the Wild made trying to get out of their zone. And right there, that one at the blue line of the offensive zone. Those are some of the key areas.
Trying to get it across for Zucker just off the bench. Now Zucker to the line for Dumba. Dumba fires, saved by Markstrom, and Staal fanned on the rebound out of midair. Cullen ducks around Hutton. Cullen works in, centered, and a backhander by Winnick is stopped by Markstrom. Tanev plays it off the glass. Zucker unable to deflect. Vertanen couldn't get it by Dumba, who centers, and that's deflected wide by Zucker. Ennis hands it off to Spurgeon. Back around behind, too far for Foligno. Suter able to hold the zone. Gives to Spurgeon, wide, fire, saved by Markstrom.
Don't leave yourself wide open for that. Wild with some good pressure here.
Foligno deflects it neatly for Coyle. Coyle comes to center. Over the Vancouver line for Ennis. Back to Spurgeon, a drive, saved by Markstrom. And the rebound just out of the reach of Foligno is collected by Staal at center ice. He finds Brodin in stride. Brodin jumps around Granlund. A backhander went just wide.
Jumped into the play. You might need your defenseman to help you out in this one. Spurgeon with a shot of contribution from blue liners.
Oh boy, what a save by Markstrom. Fakes the shot, gives to Suter in the corner. Suter into the circle. Ennis a shot and a save by Markstrom.
You see Ennis will step back up a little bit higher as Wild had Suter drop down to the half wall.
Good Branson. Has it knocked away by Stahl. Stahl to Winnick, he scores!
There's some payoff from a couple of good forechecks. Good job there, Stahl. And then Parisi squirts it loose for him. Make a couple of quick passes, and while they're able to make a difference.
Should be an assist for both Parisi and Stahl. Spins it back down low to Granlund. Granlund to Koivu, a shot, save Markstrom. Zucker has the rebound back of the net.
They're beating a couple of pretty solid Central Division teams and knowing that you're going on the break the next day.
Granlund in, back to Zucker, and it just failed to click. Picks it up the wall, Parisi quickly across for Winnick. Winnick to Stahl at center. Stahl cuts in, fires, and a save by Winnick.
With a good jump through the middle of the ice.
Tanev holds his own for Vancouver. Long shot got through and a pad saved by Dubnyk. Gagne fires, they score! And this will tie it at two with 3:12 left.
Well, that one came through a screen, and yeah, it looked like it came through the body of Vanek and dropped down. Just an awkward bounce, and yes, it went between the legs of Devan Dubnyk. He was reaching out, and when it hit Vanek, it dropped straight down and five hole. It caught one deflection, and right there catches a bit of Vanek and wobbles between the pads of Dubnyk before it finds its way into the back of the net.
Besser, Tanev, and Gagne, the trio for the Canucks. Wild weave their way through neutral ice. Granlund sidesteps Besser. Good at the line. Granlund, Spurgeon fires, and a save by Markstrom.
Boy, what a save by Markstrom.
Drops for Suter, a shot, and that deflects wide. Suter has it back. Centers, and Stahl's denied by Markstrom. Wild have had a couple of brilliant chances in this extra session. Sutter drives to the middle and scores.
This is a tough play for a goaltender because you got to move side to side while also trying to manage which side he's going to shoot the puck on, and he ends up going against the grain.
Well, the Wild had a couple of terrific chances to win this game in overtime, and Markstrom stopped him, and the Canucks end up winners at the other end.